So you guys, I am at my primary doctor and they just took my blood pressure and they said that it was a little high. Y'all know I love the art here. So yeah, they said it's a little high. But I told them that, hold on, let me get comfortable. I've been eating a lot of snacks. A lot of snacks. My weight. I done gained some weight, y'all. I now weigh 155, y'all. Ooh. Let me see what my doctor gonna say when he come in here. Cause y'all know he like me. He like me being thicker than a Snickers, so I wonder what he gonna say about my weight. My other doctor, she came to the house last week. She said everything was good. I hope they're not gonna give me no shot today, cause who don't want no shot is me. And my doctor know I don't like no shots. And he was like, I haven't seen you in a long time. Yeah, I know you ain't seen me in a long time, but you're not gonna give me no shot. So if he think he finna give me a shot, yeah, I'm about to run up out of here for real though. I'm trying to do better. I ate a salad for dinner yesterday. Trying to, well, y'all know I still drink my smoothies every day. I'm trying to eat more salads. What kind of salad I had? It was I think it was Santa Fe salad because it had corn. Yeah, it had some corn on it. It was good. The sauce was orange. Had cheese. It was good. I'm trying to do better. I'm trying to eat healthy. But now I got something to tell y'all. I got something to tell y'all. So I met this guy. I'm always meeting a guy. So I met this guy. You know what I'm saying? And mind you, we are at a doctor's office. So you can't be friendly with too many people at the doctor's office. But we was talking and everything. You know, when we have a doctor's appointment, you have a lot of time. Yeah, a lot of time. So he was telling me that he has a fiance and he's like, he's not too sure anymore because she doesn't want to get married. He wants to be married. He said they've been engaged for 10 years. Y'all, they've been engaged for 10 years. And y'all know, normally I would be like, yeah, you need to go ahead and marry her. But now, y'all, I see marriage way differently. So I was like, have y'all did counseling? He said, no, they ain't did counseling yet. I said, well, y'all should go to counseling and then, you know, talk about it. He said she already has kids, so she don't want any more kids. He said he understand that. He said he all for adopting kids. Okay. So this man, mind you, he in his 40s. Yeah, he was a good age. You know what I'm saying? He was a good age. But he in his 40s, and he has no kids. He's never been married before, and he wants a family. He want a family, y'all. And that's what he really want, is a family. Or whatever he said, because they don't have nobody here. Because they, how long he said they been here in Texas? Where he said he was from? So they been in Texas, I'm going to say since they been engaged. So they done moved to Texas. They don't know nobody here. He don't have nobody here. And he just wants a family with her. And since she already has two kids, he just wants to marry her so that it'll be official. He said he'll feel like they'll be an official family if they get married. But she don't want to get married or whatever. And I was like, well, how many kids she have? He was like, I think he said she had like three kids, whatever. And he said he take care of her kids. He take care of her. He said he take care of everything. But she doesn't want to get married. And he said they've been engaged for 10 years. Girl, go ahead and marry that man. I mean, he seem nice. He got to be nice if you've been with him for that long. Stop playing with his time. I know some females out there who would love to have a man like that, who would take care of, you know, them and their kids and love on them. She just don't know. I invited them to the church. I invited them to the church so I can get to know them better and so I could talk to them, because I got to spend some time and talk to him. I want to talk to her too and see what's the real deal, because you know it's always two sides to a story. You know that. So my doctor, he said, because my blood pressure is high, he said I need a blood pressure machine to check my blood pressure at home. And he said that I gotta stop eating so many berries, like strawberries and whatnot, because y'all not be putting that in my smoothies. He said that can make my blood pressure high. So he said stop doing that. No more strawberries, y'all. Y'all know I like that in my smoothie. So he said stop doing so many strawberries. He said to stop doing potatoes. Y'all know I love potatoes. He said stop doing potatoes, because y'all know I be eating baked potatoes all the time. He said keep doing my salad. He said, but the dressing, he said, don't do no ranch dressing. No ranch dressing. He said, no kind of creamy dressing. He said, do like a vinaigrette. He said, do some lemon or something like that. I want that on my salad. But that's what he told me to do, y'all. He said, he proud of me for everything else. He said, he just want to keep an eye on my blood pressure. So when I get this blood pressure machine, I'm gonna have to be taking my blood pressure, make sure it stays good or whatever. He said the top number good. He said it's the bottom number that he's worried about. He said could the bottom number be real high. So I got a bunch of strawberries at the house that I'm gonna have to finish, you know, because I don't believe in throwaway food. I can give it to the girls, I guess. But he liked the fact. He said everything else is good. Yeah, I really, 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 really like strawberries in my smoothie. He said, what else he said? What other fruit? He said, because I told him sometimes I do pineapple or whatever. He said, everything is fine. He said, it's just them berries that can make everything raise. It's the berries. I gotta stay away from strawberries, y'all. What am I gonna do, y'all? But yeah, my doctor. But I need to fix my brace, y'all, because my brace is messed up. I'm going to go home and put some duct tape on it, y'all. Let me show my brace to y'all how raggedy. Y'all, look at this. This bad book, look at this. This not supposed to be like this. It's supposed to be. So I need to put some duct tape or some glue or something on there so that it will stay. Yeah. He said I don't have no swelling on my legs, so he said that's good. So he proud of me for not having no swelling. Only thing that's swollen is these thighs, because big thighs save lives. See, there goes the famous art that we love so much. So like the doctor said that I need to be careful about my blood pressure. They're gonna give me my results from taking my blood, because as you can see, they did take my blood and they got it on the first time, so I'm glad about that. I told them that after this time, they should not have to take my blood for quite a while. Like I said, let a whole 6 months 6 or 7 months go by before y'all need my blood again. Because, first of all, y'all know when I went to my neurologist, this is my primary doctor, Bob. I went to my neurologist, they took my blood, and I asked them, because remember they took how many tubes did they fill up at the neurologist? They filled up, what, 10, 8? I don't know, y'all. They filled up a lot of tubes, and I told them that. I said, they took a lot of my blood at the neurologist. I was like, y'all not all connected? And they said, no, they not connected. I was like, y'all can't go to wherever they put my blood and get the results? And they was like, nah, because that's a whole different thing. And I said, as much as I paid them, that's another thing I told them. I said, the neurologist is expensive. And they said, yeah, the neurologist, they do charge a lot. I was like, yeah. I was like, I feel like I should get my money back. Somebody should give my money back. And they was like, they agree because it is expensive to go to a neurologist. Baby, I can't believe that person just climbed all them stairs, y'all. That's a lot of stairs out there. Like, when I say a lot, it's like over 100 stairs to get to the top. Like, I don't know. I don't take the stairs. I go down the ramp, because the ramp is a little bitty ramp. Y'all know how to the ramps. I really don't even like ramps. But I'll take that ramp or whatever to get, like, if you go over there by that pole, it's a little small short ramp. But if you go by these stairs over there, y'all, it's like 100 stairs to climb. Baby, I remember the first time I tried to climb them stairs and I had my walker, you know, it was me and Chalka. Baby, we almost fell down them stairs. And that's what they told me, that's the only entryway is up them stairs. So that's why I had tried it, y'all, but it was a fail. But anyways, y'all, I am Deshaun. I thank y'all for coming along with me to my doctor's appointment. I want y'all to know that Jesus loves you. You can talk to him anytime, any place, about anything, and he will always be there for you. Thanks for watching. Make sure you thumbs up the video.